Welcome back to my channel. That line never gets old. Okay, so I'm back with another cooking video, one of those videos that are supposed to show you that you can cook those meals that make you miss home right here at Res. Yes, yeah, I'm back with that. Today I'll be cooking pork trotters and samp. I have a very like detailed video on how to cook samp, so you can check that out. Yeah, let me show you on my progress. Yeah, I hope you're good. I've been good. Okay, so let's start with the trotters, guys. Just make sure your trotters are clean. This is a pig we're talking about, so make sure you get rid of the dead skin. You use a clean razor to shave off the hair that can be found on trotters. Mine were thinly sliced, so it won't take that long to cook them. Yeah, just make sure the dead skin is off. Then I was just now gonna add I was making that one smaller. Yes, I was making that one, cutting it a bit smaller. And then I started adding in all the spices I was going to need. First was water to the level of the trotters, a quarter of an onion. Then I added a third of a cube of the curry vegetable flavor, some steak and chops spice. This is the real OG, guys. It's used in Nigerian food. It's a Maggi cube. It just elevates your pot. This is garlic and herb flakes and some chili flakes in there. Shake, you know, we want it hot. Yeah, and then just shake it all up together. I like to put in all the spices before so that like it just all comes together. Put that on the stove at like medium to high heat.
Okay, so I have put the pork trotters on the stove. I'm gonna let them boil for at least 45 minutes so that they can be really tender. I put all the spices in there so that all the flavors can just, you know, conglomerate. Now what I want to do is there's people over there, that's why I keep looking. What I want to do now is to just start making the gravy or the sauce for the trotters, so that when they're done boiling, I'm just gonna put them in there. Yeah, the samp is also coming along well. Like I said, there is a video for that, so check it out.
Okay, so to make that sauce, start with like oil. I didn't have oil, that's why I'm using margarine. And then some onions, that was probably a full onion. 2 teaspoons of crushed garlic. And then this is tomato puree. You can use crushed tomatoes or fresh tomatoes. This was easiest for me, that's why I went with this route. I wanted it to be very tomato-y. Yeah, and then okay, I added a third of this cube again. I really like this cube, guys. It's not dominant, but it adds a nice flavor. I just crushed that in there. Then I added about half a teaspoon of salt. Yeah, and then just stir it all up together. You need to keep stirring because otherwise it will stick to the bottom of the pot. Like, it's not necessarily burning, but it's sticking there. I added some more chili. I love chili. I'm sure you know this already. I love chili. And then I added some chutney. Where's the chutney? There's the chutney. I added some chutney just to balance out the salt, the sourness of the tomato. Added some frozen vegetables, and then I used the water from the trotters. Just, you know, we want maximum flavor, so don't add fresh water. Yeah, so I added that water in the sauce. At this point, like, my sauce was sticking to the bottom of the pot. Then I added some basil. Elevates the whole dish, adds so much flavor. The smell, ah, I love basil, guys. I love basil. Then after adding the basil, I just like removed the sauce from the pan because I just wanted to wash it. At this point, it was just sticking too much. You need to keep stirring, and maybe it's also because I used margarine instead of oil, I suspect. So I just wanted to wash the pan. Then after washing it, I added a bit of margarine again. Added the trotters into the clean pan, and then after that I added the sauce in there. Oh, That sauce smells so good. I actually wish I ate this with pap and not samp. Yeah. Then I'm just like mixing everything together. Mix it all up together. Smells delicious, or smelled delicious rather.
Hey guys, so I've been in the kitchen for an hour and a half and I'm done with my trotters. I just switched off the stove. This is the final product. Now we're waiting on the samp. It needs like half an hour more. So 30 more minutes, then I'll be done. I just need to wash dishes. Yeah. It smells divine, honey.
I'm back in my room, you guys, and I definitely dished up too much food. It's way too much. It tastes good. Yeah, it tastes good. I was supposed to leave the samp on for a little longer, so it's not as soft as it should be. The trotters are nice. The basil gives it a nice taste. They're delicious. Thank you so much for watching this video. In the previous video where I cooked pap and ox liver, someone did ask for a trotters cooking video, and here it is. So I hope you enjoyed it. The trotters are amazing. The samp should have been on the stove for a little longer, but it still tastes good, guys. It tastes nice. I mean, my cooking is really getting better and better. Yeah. Yeah. So it's decent, it's nice. Thank you so much for watching the video. I do hope you enjoyed watching me cook and eat. Yeah, let me know in the comment section what other kind of cooking videos you'd like to see. And thank you so much for liking the video, because I know you liked it, right? Right? And thank you for clicking the subscribe button, because you are subscribed now, right? Yeah, leave a comment down in the comment section, and I love you so much.